everybody. My name is Matt Elliott, and I'm at the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon on Highway 99. Today, I want to show you the nicest example of a 2019 Winnebago Era that you're probably ever going to see. This thing is neat as a pin, and it's a really cool floor plan. Really briefly, though, I want to talk to you first about just the nature of Class B motorhomes. Class B motorhomes are so sought after and desirable by both young people doing their first RV. They want something they can be active in, and also other people who've had a lot of big RVs and they just want something they can go in with so much less planning. There's a lot of freedom in a B van. One other thing that I really love about the Class Bs is that most of the traditional maintenance issues that you have with motorhomes have to do with the body construction being fiberglass, laminated parts, lots of plastic and stuff on motorhomes. This is all Mercedes. This whole roof, that's intact. All the original integrities that Mercedes built into this commercial chassis, they're all there, all the safety stuff. And it's a lot less likely to ever have a leak, a squeak, or a rattle because this whole body is the same integrity as a Mercedes. You can buy this motorhome, leave it in your driveway for 20 years, and it's still going to be just as good as an exterior as it is right now. So that's something I really admire about this style of RV. Now, what you see on this is excellent condition. So we're going to go around the outside and point out some of these things. This has a brand new set of Michelin tires on it. It's got gorgeous alloy wheels. It's got a great big running board, very easy to get in and out. It has a power awning and it's got a light strip in it. You just push a button and that awning comes out. And you'll notice that there isn't any clips on the side. With this one here, when the awning comes out, you don't have to mount your clips on the side of your coach so that bar doesn't come right down in your head area. Beautiful tinted windows, outside lights in your area, outside speakers. I mean, I'm just hitting these high points really quick because I've got so much to show you on this coach. Now, this is something that I absolutely love about this floor plan. Most Class Bs don't have any storage. They don't have any outside storage because they don't have that kind of a body. You really got to learn to pack light. And this one has a really good interior storage area, and this is the high point right here. So with this one, instead of having a couch right in the back or a bathroom right in the back, it's got the bedding arrangement and it leaves the entire undercarriage area here under the bed wide open. I've even got a Joey, I call these Joey boxes, where I can put stuff here. I've got a great big area back there. I can stack stuff up here. If I am a rock climber or a scuba diver or, you know, a photographer, whatever hobby I've got, I can put my stuff here and have it ready to go. I know people who use these vans for work too, because they can put all their tools and supplies right there. It's very, very useful. I love that. Okay, so now these doors here also will open all the way around, so you can really get a lot closer to your project or whatever you're doing. Anyway, oh, one other thing. This has, right here, we have a privacy screen, and we've got here, we've got a see-through screen, so I can have my doors open, I get a lot of fresh air, and not get a lot of bugs. So that is really, really a wonderful design. It changes a little bit about how the inside works, but that's very good too. Now, see this ladder? There's a roof rack up on top of this ladder. There's 200 watts of solar up on the roof. You can go up, service your roof, clean it, clean the panels, take them on and off. You could put a kayak rack. This has a whole full-length roof rack. You can do all kinds of things with that roof space that you can't do on most coaches. So this ladder can be removed, and then I can move that ladder wherever I want to up the side of the coach. Extremely useful. Okay, let's go this way. One of the other really cool things about a camper van is they don't look like a motorhome. So they're very attractive, very sleek. I love the monochrome appearance on this particular one. But if you're in an association neighborhood and you've got to park something in your driveway, most RVers have to get outside storage, so they can't get away with it. But a lot of association neighborhoods will just look at this as if it's a normal passenger vehicle that you might buy. And so you can keep them in your driveway. It's certainly worth the argument. And then all of your plumbing and fixtures are down low here. So they aren't, you know, bolting everything into the side of the coach. It's a very, very nicely done design. So here's another really cool thing on this particular version of the Winnebago Era. It's got a TV up here. Now the TV lines up with the passenger seats over here, so you can watch TV from those even while you're driving. But look at this. Hey, now I've got a tailgater. I can put my awning out, set my lawn chairs out here, and we can be outside and watch TV. You can have a lot of fun with that setup. Okay, so now we're on the inside of this beautiful 2019 Winnebago Era. Such a cool rig. And I want to say really quick that Winnebago is well known for building quality. And one of their unique features is that they hand build these vans to the degree that they make their own holding tanks and their own shower enclosures. A lot of the bits and pieces that you would typically buy from a vendor, Winnebago builds themselves. So there's two benefits. One, better quality control. And two, if you ever need to get something for them, it's a lot easier to get one from Winnebago because they keep all the schematics and dies and everything that they need to remanufacture a part. So it really keeps things from getting obsolete. I love that about this company. They're you know, of course, well known in the industry for over 50 years. Now, when you look inside this coach, first thing you notice as you walk in, you don't have to duck to get in it. Most of the camper vans have a little lower roof lines and they're harder to get in. Tall guys enjoy this one. There's plenty of room in here. If you're, you know, 6'2", you're still probably going to be okay. And then we have a very nice galley. It's got really good deep storage here. And then that storage area is actually accessible from the outside too. I've got an outside access to that same compartment. Down here, we've got another big basin. You know, this is good enough to put a garbage can in. You have enough room. You can see water filtration is right there and it's easy to get to. You don't have to be some kind of a squirrel monkey to get your water filter changed. Got a nice two burner propane stove. Got a really deep recessed sink with a single handle faucet. That works really great. As I mentioned earlier, this trailer is hand built. They make their own cabinets. So now when we look at the quality of craftsmanship on this, is really superb. I mean, everything's built well. The you know, this is a 2019, and this is all just exactly like a brand new one. It looks exactly brand new the way that they build these cabinets. If we lift this one up, we've got a media center right there and a place to plug in whatever devices I want. So let's say I want to have a satellite receiver, a video game player, or something like that. All the AVI plugs are in there. It makes it easy. So another thing I want to point out is in here, they use LED type lighting. It's very attractive, the design with these sort of rope light designs. And the thing that's cool is they're dimmable, so I can change the level of light if I want them dimmer, and then I can do that throughout this coach and the vehicle will remember my setting. So I can change it, but I don't have to all the time. Microwave oven right here, and this is called a NovaCool fridge. And this is something that I really, really like because it's a 12 volt electric fridge. It doesn't need any propane at all. So that means I can leave it on while I'm driving. And also it means it's bigger because that propane cooling equipment that goes in behind your fridge takes up a lot of room. So that's why RV fridges seem so small. But this is a small fridge. It still has a pretty good amount of space. And then here, down here, that's our freezer. So you can take ice cream. Yay, ice cream. If you look up, you'll see that we have a high capacity exhaust fan. This is very important because I can get air out of this coach. When you use a B van, you're making a lot of moisture in a small space because, you know, so that air gets moisture in it from breathing and cooking and showering. If I can turn on that exhaust fan, I can bring in nice fresh air and get the moisture out. I don't have all that condensation and mildew and stuff, that dankness that gets into an RV. Look at, whoa, that drawer really works good. Look at the quality of the workmanship on this drawer. It's on roller guides. They're all nice, big, deep drawers. Right here is my controller for my Truma Combi heating system. This does both the heat and the hot water, and it's really, really nice the way that it works. This is the controller for my solar panel, and this guy here is a touchscreen controller that lets me operate everything in the coach from a touchscreen, even start the generator and do stuff like that. And it's got a 1,000-watt inverter. Now this coach actually has a couple of TVs in it. It's got some 110 outlets. And by using my my inverter control, I could turn on my inverter and use those appliances without being plugged in or turning on my generator. And that's really cool. It's not enough to run your air conditioner, but it'll let you watch TV or, you know, make some toast or whatever. Now, we come back here and let's take a look at the bathroom. Now, a lot of camper vans have very small bathrooms. This one actually is pretty big, and it's roomy enough for you to use. If you're really tall, then when you take your shower, you're going to sit on that toilet and use that while you're taking your shower. But that's not too big a problem. And then the other thing is that a lot of people don't really use these showers unless they have to. So you've got a curtain rack, and I can actually use this to hang my clothes too. All one piece fiberglass. And again, this is something that Winnebago makes themselves. They don't buy that from some vendor. They make their own, and it's fiberglass. It's really good. Now, here's what makes that whole rear storage thing possible. I have got a twin bed model. There's a centerpiece in this closet that drops right here if I want to make it all into one bed. But the twin bed kind of makes sense to me because now I can get in and out of bed just by dropping my feet and standing up. I don't have to crawl. And if I'm going to use bed rolls and just lay them out, I can just leave them that way all the time. This has cool little headrests under here. And so I can set this up, watch TV, read a book or whatever. And then I have access to that back storage area down here. Remember the rear storage I showed you? I can get into there. Now in the front two seats swivel, and there's a jump seat up there that can be made into an additional bed. And also there's a table that fits especially in that area. So you can have two people in the jump seat and then people in each of the swivel front seats and make that into a social area, a dining table. But it goes away, which is what I like, because I don't need that table all the time. So I got to put it away and get it out of here. It lives down here. Excuse me. Lots of overhead storage. This coach is just one of the most useful, versatile designs you're ever going to see. So yeah, I it's hard to beat, and it's only got like 32,000 miles. We haven't even detailed this coach yet. This is just as clean as it came in. And the previous owner is obviously a very fastidious person who takes very good care of his coach. Okay, now as you look forward from the bedroom, you see we've got a TV built in right here. There's really a nice, I can't see what's in there, but I know that the cushion for the middle part of the bed is in there. And you know, if you're not going to use that, you can just leave that at home and you don't have to give up the storage space. There's some other things in there too. Now, as we go forward, I also want to show you the Mercedes part of this, because when you look at a Mercedes, first of all, they're very ergonomic. You've got steering wheel controls for your driver information center, your Bluetooth controls for your phone. This has the original stereo from Mercedes in it, and it's a really good piece of equipment. I love the way they work. And the thing that's really cool about a Mercedes is they don't have a great big motor housing, so you have plenty of room in the front where your feet and your knees go. It's easy to get in and out of these chairs. You have a lot of footwell space. So especially taller people find these are a lot more comfortable to drive than a Ford or a Dodge Ram, just because of foot placement and ease of access. So, well, especially the Fords, because they have a bigger motor housing. So that's a quick look at the 2019 Winnebago Era 70A. Such a great Class B motorhome, and this is the nicest example of one you're going to run into. I hope you enjoyed the video. I'd love to talk to you too directly, so please feel free to give me a call. My name is Matt Elliott. You can reach me at 541-954-8495. Thanks a bunch. You have a great day.